We are so grateful to the Education Edge Foundation for funding this project that you are seeing. For years, the Education Edge has provided auditorium enhancements through sound and lighting instruments, but this year we've been able to take that extra step, serving round two of our backdrop project. This has given an opportunity for each of our high schools to think about a scene that they'd like to see imposed on a backdrop. Through this process, we were able to once again contract with Rachel Downs, who did our first round. She is an excellent artist, facilitator, educator of kids. We were so pleased to have her back. And this time, Rachel was able to subcontract three world-class designers, one of them being her husband, Michael, who was a 1981 outstanding graduate of our own Wichita Southeast High School.
The first part of the process is that you have to have a design. That all happens before any students show up. We meet with the director, they decide what they want, they give us a research picture. Last time I designed most of them, this time I have three amazing designers who designed the backdrops. Michael designed three, my friend Jordan Slusher designed three, and Shuzheng He designed three.
When we did it before, it was like all hands on deck getting it done. This time we scheduled it so that it wouldn't be as breakneck speed all the way through. The plan was to give multiple designers an opportunity to design three drops themselves for those particular high schools. We discussed with the theater teachers what they needed, whether it was a sky background or whether it was an urban setting or whether it was forest. So we created them, designed them, got feedback from the teachers about whether that's what they wanted. Everybody loved it. And then my wife has to figure out how to paint it all.
The backdrop is 20 feet by 40 feet, so it fills the whole stage. So essentially you can get an entire scene that you can fold up and it becomes 24 by 36 when it's folded, and you can store it. And then you can get it out, hang it on the batten, and use it. And so you can use it to shift scenery behind for a crossover scene, or you can use it a myriad of different ways. But when you do a musical, sometimes you have anywhere from 15 to 35 scenes, maybe more, that you need. So you need a lot of scenery. So if you have to build every single piece every single time, it becomes unaffordable.
As a set designer, you can design a heck of a plywood box, right? But if you don't have a really great painter, that plywood box can never be a throne.
To provide a backdrop that provides that excellent setting for our students to take audience members into that particular scene gives that performance an added dimension.
When the kids show up, we staple it down, we starch it, and then we try to get it all laid out. Usually if we have to lay out architecture, there's a lot more measuring involved, so that takes us a little bit longer. When it's drawn in charcoal, we put the whole design in permanent marker, and then we start mixing colors. We base coat it, and then we just start layering, and usually we paint from back to front. So then the next few days are spent like learning all the crazy techniques of scenic painting. Stone and tree bark and foliage and wood grain and highlight and shadow and where to put it and how to put it on, and encouraging the kids to keep looking at the picture. We're trying to make it look like this picture, and they get into it. And they're amazing. Honestly, they work really hard and they're super proud of it when they get done. It's really, really fun.
The Wichita Public Schools Fine Arts was extremely fortunate to contract with Rachel Downs. In addition to being an outstanding painter, designer, she is a master with our kids. She involves our students in every component of the process of these excellent productions.
I get so much out of it. I mean, I get to do my favorite thing and teach other people how to do it and pass on what I know.
This is the best, right?
Yeah.
This is the best.